Hey, Tim DeStasio here at my house. As most of you know, I had this house built in 2023 and I made some energy efficiency and envelope upgrades so that my house could be not only more comfortable, but healthier and safer and more energy efficient as well. Now, one of the other things that I did was install my own HVAC system and I selected the Bosch BOVB 18 SEER split heat pump. Now, Bosch has gotten a little bit of a bad rap unfairly because a lot of people do not understand how to properly set these things up, and then they complain when it doesn't perform well, especially in dehumidification. But here I am in coastal North Carolina, and I'm going to show you how I set my unit up all the way from the design to the commissioning so that this unit is very comfortable as well as dehumidifies very well. So follow me along as I show you what I did to get the most performance out of my Bosch heat pump. The first thing that I did was start with a manual J heat load calculation, and I have really documented this in earlier videos. If you want to learn more about that, you can go over to my playlist on YouTube at Tim DeStasio HVAC, and then the playlist is my Southport house. Now, a manual J heat load calculation is going to calculate how much sensible as well as latent heat, which calculates how much dry heat as well as how much heat and moisture that needs to be removed on a typical summer day. Now, in addition to a heat load calculation, we then need to match the capacity, the cooling capacity of the heat pump to that heat load calculation, not only for air conditioning, but also in heating mode. Now, I do what we call aggressively sized systems, which means that I take as much credit for things that could help the house stay cooler, as opposed to oversizing the equipment, which could hurt me in the long run. My heat load calculation came to somewhere around 2 tons of cooling load. One feature that I really like about Bosch is that you're able to turn their 3-ton into a 2-ton with just a dip switch, which I'll show you here in a few minutes. And then their 5-ton model, you can turn into a 4-ton, same thing with a dip switch. So it really simplifies what you need to keep on stock as a contractor, and it gives you a lot of choices for setup here just inside the unit. All right, with the power off, I want to explain what this dip switch bank number 4 does. So we're really only concentrating on dip switches number 3 and 4. Switch number 3 is what we call adaptive capacity. When that switch is turned off, adaptive capacity is turned on. I know it's a little bit backwards. It allows the board here to make some decisions outside of its normal algorithm to kind of change how much cooling the system is making to increase the runtime and decrease how much cycling. This is essential to getting the Bosch unit to dehumidify properly. You've got to turn switch number 3 off. Switch number 4 is what we call accelerated cooling capacity. And when that is turned on, this unit will try to attempt to control to a lower saturation temperature. So when we have a colder coil, a lower saturation temperature here, when that switch number 4 is turned on, then we will dehumidify better. So for a Bosch unit to dehumidify very well, switch number 3 needs to be off, switch number 4 needs to be on. One feature that I really like about Bosch is that in their 18 SEER models, currently they only make 2 models. A 3-ton and a 5-ton, and you're able to turn their 3-ton into a 2-ton with just a dip switch, which I'll show you here in a few minutes. And then their 5-ton model, you can turn into a 4-ton, same thing with a dip switch. So it really simplifies what you need to keep on stock as a contractor, and it gives you a lot of choices for setup here just inside the unit. J2, which is the black dip switch, is what they call a jumper. This is our capacity selection. I have mine set for 2-ton. Because that's all my load calculation required. One reason that makes Bosch so special is that it has a variable speed compressor in it, but it does not control the speed of that compressor the way typically manufacturers control variable speed units. With most manufacturers, their variable speed equipment speeds up and slows down based on how far the temperature in the house is from the actual thermostat set point. But with Bosch, it simply maintains a set indoor coil temperature by converting pressure into an estimated temperature, and it speeds up and slows down to maintain that temperature. But the reason why this is so effective is that you essentially set your capacity, your air conditioning capacity, based on your blower speed and your airflow. So let's go over to my air handler and I'll show you how to set the airflow up to the lowest speed possible so that we can aggressively size how much capacity that this heat pump actually delivers. This is my Bosch air handler, and because I only had about 2 tons of cooling load, I could have selected the 2-ton air handler, but instead I decided to select the 3-ton air handler and match it with the 2-ton setting out there. And that's because I wanted a larger evaporator coil to give me a little bit more latent cooling. That larger coil equates to a larger surface area. It also still gives me the ability to set my blower speed down a considerable amount, well below what a typical 2-ton air conditioning unit would need, and that would allow my compressor outside to match that airflow with the amount of refrigeration it needed in order to maintain safe operating temperatures and pressures for the unit out there. Now I'm going to show you what I did to set these blower speeds. Inside the air handler, there is a set of dip switches, and those dip switches have various configurations that can give you various speed profiles. Currently, these dip switches are set at their lowest speed, which means that this blower is going to operate at the lowest speed possible. The air handler is also a 2-stage air handler, which means that it only runs 2 speeds. It either gets a call for first stage cooling, and then if the thermostat determines that first stage is not enough to properly cool the system, it'll engage second stage, which allows the air handler to run a little bit faster. So far, we've talked about how the Bosch's variable speed compressor reacts to the amount of airflow that we set the blower up to move and speeds up and slows down to maintain a constant coil temperature. The more airflow that we set the air handler to move, the more capacity that the compressor will have to make in order to maintain those temperatures. By tuning down the amount of airflow that we're asking it to make, we in turn allow the compressor outside to also slow down and increase runtime. And that is the secret to making a Bosch dehumidify very well. Now, another very helpful and essential tool to making that possible is having a thermostat that has the settings that we need in order to increase the runtime and make sure that we get the most out of our Bosch heat pump. This is the Ecobee Smart Thermostat Premium, and this is the model thermostat that I will always suggest that you get and pair with your Bosch heat pump so that we can get the most out of it. I'm going to take you through some of the installer settings that I have found that makes my system run the longest and allows it to dehumidify the best. The first thing that we're going to do is choose our settings button, and we're going to scroll down to the settings part of the menu. From here, we want to go to installation settings. Let's first take a look at our equipment settings. Notice that my heat pump is set for 2-stage. The air handler is a 2-stage air handler. The outdoor unit, because it's a variable speed, only requires 1 stage of cooling control wiring. Let's next go to reconfigure equipment. You definitely want to select that you're an Ecobee Pro. You're going to go through a lot of these settings as you normally would as an HVAC contractor. In this case, we're going to select only RC is connected. Even though we do have a 2-stage air handler, we want to select single or variable speed fan. We want to verify that our wiring is correct. We also want to verify that not only Y1, but also Y2 has a control wire connected to it, because those are the cooling stages that our air handler will need to have so it knows what speed to run the blower. Once we set all that up, the next thing that we need to do is set up our thresholds. There are some very important settings here that are crucial to getting the most out of our Bosch heat pump. One of the first settings under thresholds that we want to make sure that we set correctly is configure staging needs to be set to manually. That way we can make some additional changes to how the compressors stage so that we can keep this unit running as long as possible. We want to disable AC overcool max, so there's no need to enable this setting. The next setting that we'll talk about is cool differential setting. If we set this too low, then the unit may short cycle because it's only going to turn the compressor on at a half a degree above the set point. So if we have the thermostat set at 75 degrees, it would turn the first stage of cooling on at 75.5. I found that a really good balance is setting this at 1 or 1.5. That way we're not allowing the temperature in the house to deviate too far past set point, but we still are allowing good solid run cycles. The next setting is cool dissipation time. This is how long that your blower will run after a cooling cycle and the compressor cycles off. We do not want the blower to run any time that the compressor is not running, because this can re-evaporate the water that was left on the coil. We want that water to drain out so that it does not evaporate back into the air and add to the humidity in the space. So we want to leave this at zero. The next setting is compressor minimum on time. We want to set this to at least 10 minutes because anytime the compressor comes on, we want it to remove moisture, especially in a humid climate. If we don't let it run at least 10 minutes, then the coil may not get cold enough to actually start pulling water out. Compressor reverse staging. This is one of the most important settings that we want to have on. And when our temperature indoors has gotten warm enough where it needs second stage cooling, we don't want it to stay in second stage all the way down to when the thermostat can satisfy. Rather, we want it to reverse stage, going back to first stage cooling as we start to bring the temperature of the space down. So we want to turn this on so we can maximize the runtime, allow the compressor to continue running even in first stage cooling, because we will continue to pull water out of the air. Compressor stage 2, temperature delta. We want to have it at least 1 degree higher than whatever we set our cool differential temperature for. We can think about the cool differential temperature as stage 1, and our compressor stage 2 temperature delta is how many degrees above set point that our stage 2 is going to come on. In this case, I've got it set to 2 degrees. It seems to be a nice balance. If you set any higher than that, you risk having comfort problems because the space will continue to get hotter and hotter before stage 2 comes on. Finally, we want to make sure that our temperature and humidity is properly calibrated with a trusted second device. So I've done that here. I've not only applied a temperature correction, but also a humidity correction based on the second instrument that I very much trust. That way, we're as accurate as possible when we're making adjustments to this thermostat. Here's another secret about how the Bosch thinks. When it's running in second stage cooling, and because we've set up the reverse cycling to back down into first stage cooling, the blower immediately slows down, but the compressor outside takes about 15 or 16 minutes to get all the way back down to speed. And so you run into this really robust dehumidification cycle where the blower is running slower, but the compressor is still ramped up, driving your coil pressure down. That brings down your coil temperature, and cold temperatures equals drier air. So it's really important to set up the reverse cycling for that reason as well. Here we see a typical 24-hour period as recorded by Ecobee. That's another reason why I like the Ecobee thermostat, because we get all this data. So we can see stage 2, which is the dark blue band, comes on just a little bit in the afternoon, but then stage 1 is running a lot. We're getting good solid run times during the heat of the day. And look at that white humidity line. It stays in between 50 and 60% for the most part, despite there being very high outdoor humidity, as can be seen by the green line. I've been tracking my Bosch's performance all year, and this is very common. With very long run cycles, I get very cold air coming out, and cold means dry. And when I quantify the performance based on all those readings, I get a staggering 7.5 pints or pounds of water per hour removed during a continuous run cycle. You just can't beat that. So it's important to note that I've also done a lot of things to make sure that my Bosch heat pump doesn't have a lot of moisture it has to get rid of in the first place. I've got a really tight building envelope. I do pull in fresh air, and that fresh air has a lot of humidity, but I only pull in fresh air when the indoor air quality in my house requires it. And I've also got a small dehumidifier here, the smallest one that Santa Fe makes, that is there to help dehumidify the house during humid weather, but mild weather, when the call for air conditioning just isn't there to get those compressor run times. But I hope you can see that with just a little bit of setup and understanding how the Bosch system thinks, you can get really good performance out of this, their middle-of-the-line 24-volt non-communicating model. So if you're a contractor and you're interested in getting more out of the Bosch systems that you install, let me know and I'll be happy to help design a system that works for your clients. And if you're a homeowner in the Cape Fear area, Brunswick or New Hanover County, North Carolina, I'll be happy to be your Bosch HVAC contractor. For now, thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.